So the farmers go out and plant seeds and grow food. They trade around for their daily needs and store surplus food for the winter. Or maybe next year one of them has a bad crop and they help him out with a little. Up at the clan level, and up at the level of the tribe, they collect their storage. Now, in eco-language, sometimes if we zoom in to look at a part, everything else goes off screen. So let's agree to regroup or re-chunk the lower levels, here into families and then into clans, in order to keep it simple and to keep everything on screen. So the central compound contained the chief and the shamans or the priests, of course the storehouse. They built a wall around it, making it the first village. Everybody else ran into there in case of an outside attack. And in peaceful times, this is an enormously stable system. Of course, they grew a variety of crops and were surrounded by an even wider ecosystem. As the populations grew, some split off to go out and start new croplands, while others moved into the center, there to live as tradespeople. Over even longer periods of time, each farming region specialized in the crop it grew best. And they traded with each other through the town. Royal family, priests, warriors, artisans, the slaves captured in battle, the farmers out in the fields, and the distant cities with which they traded. This is the basic physical structure of the first little kingdom.